Thank you. So Mr. Frederick called me into his office a couple weeks ago. He said, I'd like to speak to you in my office. I figured I'd have trouble, but he said, the senior class would like you to speak to them at their breakfast. And I was, quite frankly, panicked. I mean, what am I supposed to say to a bunch of seniors on the last week of school? They're ready to get out. I didn't know what to do. So I went around and I sought some advice. I asked everyone I knew, what should I say to the seniors? Some people said, don't say anything heavy. They're tired of sermons. They're tired of lectures. Be light. Be funny. I'm not funny. Some people said, don't be too light. They need to leave here with some heavy advice to take into their future. I didn't know about that either. So basically, I wrote a couple of three drafts, decided those were terrible. Read a couple of things to my husband. All he did was lift his eyebrows. And finally, I sat down at my computer on Wednesday night, and I decided that I would tell you some advice that my grandmother had told me when I was about your age. She said, Callie, it's not what you do in life that is important. It's who you are. Those words have lived with me for a long time. They keep coming back all the time in my mind as being important, and they're words that I would like to tell you about today. First of all, who are you? Think about the people that have developed your character over the years. Quite likely, some of them were teachers. It might have been in the seventh grade when your PE teacher said, hey, you're a pretty good athlete. Why don't you go out for a sport? It might have been an art instructor at Borah High School who saw some talent and asked you and gave you the confidence to pursue your hobby. For me, it was my eighth grade English grammar teacher, Effie Clayton. Effie Clayton was a hardcore English grammar teacher. Some of Effie Clayton's rules were no talking, period, ever. Unless you were called on, you'd better not speak in her class. But one thing I did learn from Effie over the years, I look back and I think so fondly about what she taught me. It was a lot more than English grammar, although she did teach me a lot about English grammar. She taught me about hard work and self-discipline. She gave me a lot of confidence in my abilities. She always said, put your best work forward. Don't slack off. And those are the kinds of things that have really stuck with me. And I'm really happy that I had Effie as a teacher. In fact, I've told her that many times. She's a good friend of mine today. Others who have helped form you, the person that you are today, are your friends and your relatives. You've learned a lot about fun from your friends. Those are the people that over the last 3 or 4 years you've gone out with and had a good time with. But friends are more than that. Friends are people that you have come to trust and love, the people that have been there for you in your traumas. Your relatives have given you the support and encouragement also that you've needed to grow and change in your life. My grandmother had the most profound effect on the development of my character. She was kind and gentle, and she always urged me to be kind in my relationships with people. My grandmother was emphatic about showing people that did nice things for you, your appreciation. She urged me to become an honest and straightforward person in my relationships with people. And I don't think I would be the person I am today had my grandmother not always been there gently prodding me to do the right things in life. So here you are at the end of a long leg of your journey and ready to embark in a new direction in your lives. I hope that you will spend part of the next couple of weeks that you're here at Borah contacting those friends and relatives, teachers that have had an influence on your life and say thank you, because it is important for them that they know that you appreciate what they've done for you. The challenge for you lies ahead. How are you going to continue to develop into that person with dignity and character have three things in your life. First, you must become empathetic for the human condition. It's become so clear in the last couple of weeks with what's been going on in LA and other cities throughout the United States that we are a long ways from coming together as a nation. I don't think we can afford to harden our hearts towards people. We need to find solutions to our problems together. Secondly, I would like to encourage you to develop honesty in your relationships with people. You are all going to be going out, finding jobs, getting married, having children in the next 10 years. Believe it or not. Honesty is the only character trait that can keep those relationships together. A lack of trust can be the greatest barrier to comfort and peace in your futures. Finally, the one thing that I would encourage all of you to work on is commitment in your lives. If you have no commitment to anything in your lives, you will not accomplish anything in your lives. Half-hearted attempts and feigned apathy will only create failure. Don't be afraid to be tenacious in going after your goals. It will take a huge commitment from me and you to make our world safe for your children and my grandchildren. Well, that's my message. Become a person that you can be proud of. Don't worry about success. Good people are successful. Don't worry about money. Good people have all the wealth that money could ever buy. Think about the people that you respect and admire. Over the years, you will find that they are the people you respect, not because of what they are, but because of who they are. Thank you very much. God bless you, class of 92.
Who reportedly gushed, as Miss America,
My goal is to bring peace to the entire world and then to get my own apartment. But virtually nothing is out of your reach if you will only reach far and high enough. If you haven't already noticed, you will find a great deal of joy and beauty in this world. Take the time to look for it. Be involved. Care about yourself, others, and this world. Make this planet a better place than it was when you arrived on it. My life has centered around teaching. The real beauty of that is that if we do it right, the process is truly a cooperative one. I feel that I've learned a great deal from you. I hope that you've learned something from me. And quite possibly, in the exchange of all of that, we have exposed the most basic formula for happiness and personal success. First, let me mention a few things that I know I've learned from you this year. I've learned some new vocabulary. A lot of it, actually. Gnarly. It doesn't refer to tree bark, I discovered. Hurl. If someone has to, don't offer to catch it. I've learned something about music. The INXF are not the Inks. I thought they were a more gnarly version of the Ink Spots, a group that I remember as a little girl. And finally, some renewed social awareness. I've got to check my zippers and buttons when I come back from the women's restroom. I hope that the over 200 of you here today, who I have had at some point, either as 7th graders, 8th graders, 9th graders, sophomores, or seniors, have learned something about literature that will make your lives richer. I believe by studying the finest hopes, dreams, and thoughts that men and women have ever recorded, we learn about our lives and the lives of the people who have lived before us and who live today. Keep reading, and above all, keep learning. As D.H. Lawrence once said in regard to some famous paintings of his, even love is a thing to be learned. Last, what have we learned from each other that transcends any information we might have received from a textbook? Hopefully we've learned about honor, dedication, compassion, and love. Without these, all the rest seems somehow less significant. In closing, I want you to think for a moment about what the next 12 years may bring to you. Some of you will be established in careers. Like Callie said, some of you will be married. Some of you will live in foreign countries. Some of you will have children. Some of you will still be studying. I hope that each and every one of you has all of life's greatest blessings, and I thank you for having me here today. You've given me the opportunity to do something I've loved doing for 20 years now, and today provided me with an event at which I can read something I've wanted to read for 23 years and present to an audience. Stanley begged me not to sing it, so I will read. My own children would never forgive me if I sang the lyrics to a song that the concert choir in the high school I attended wanted to sing at our commencement. They seemed appropriate in view of the turmoil of the 1960s, but were deemed too radical and disrespectful somehow for the ceremony. It isn't exactly biology, but maybe you know it. And it goes, born free as the wind blows, as free as the grass grows, born free to follow your heart. Live free, and beauty surrounds you. The world still astounds you each time you look at a star. Stay free where no walls divide you. You're free as a roaring tide, so there's no need to hide. Born free, and life is worth living, but only worth living because you're born free. Thank you very much.
Get to see.